Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshad Devi friends and I welcome you back to my video. So in very short time, I'm going to discuss this tundra ecosystem with you. Friends, see, you have very well heard about this polar ecosystem. Okay, now what is basically this tundra ecosystem, or to be precise, tundra biome? This will be discussed by me in this video. And after this video, friends, I will be telling you the difference between tundra and taiga, friends. So this is the English version of the video. If you want to watch the Hindi version of the video, the link is given in the description box below. So this is a map. We'll come back to map in some amount of time. So basically, in this physical geography, this tundra is a biome where it is said that the temperatures are so low and the growing season is of such a short time that the tree growth is very much hindered. Okay, and that is why this tundra is also known as upland or treeless mountain tract. This is the reason that tundra is also known as treeless mountain tract. If we talk about the vegetation which comprises this tundra biome, so there you are only going to find shrubs, and those shrubs which are dwarf, that is not very long, they are not going to go very long, they are very short shrubs, very short grasses, these mosses and lichens. Now mosses and lichens are those species, friends, which are available everywhere. When life evolved on earth, the very first forms to develop were mosses and lichens. So obviously mosses and lichens are so productive that they can actually change the whole geology of a particular area. This, you know, according this role of mosses and lichens, I've already discussed in the rocks video of mine. So if you have not watched my rock video series in the geography playlist, kindly go and watch it. Okay, so basically the trees are not there in tundras. However, there are some exceptions. Some scattered trees are found in some tundra regions, but generally, and I should say mostly, there are actually no trees in tundra region, only some grasses, lichens, mosses and dwarf shrubs. Now there is one important concept here which you need to understand, is timber line or tree line. So basically, what is timber line and tree line? The ecotone. Now, what is actually ecotone, friends? When this word ecotone comes into play, I've already explored you what is ecotone in my previous environment video. So I'm not going to detail it here. It is actually a combination or the boundary of two different biomes or ecosystem or environment. Okay, kindly revise my previous video. So basically, this ecological boundary region that is known as ecotone, when there is an ecological boundary between a forest ecosystem and a tundra ecosystem, or a forest biome and a tundra biome, there comes the tree line or timber line. And then this tree line and timber line is very important for deciding whether a particular place is tundra or not. I will come to that after some amount of time. Basically, three types of tundra regions have been identified. One is Arctic tundra, second is Antarctic tundra, and third is Alpine tundra. Arctic tundra is very simple to know, friends. You know, the very northernmost region which are near the North Pole, they form the Arctic tundra. Those regions which are very much near the South Pole, the Antarctica continent, that forms the Antarctic tundra. And third, Alpine tundra, I'm going to come on it. First, let's discuss in this map. If this Antarctic tundra is not very clearly visible, if you are going to go down, then you will find the Antarctica continent. There is the Antarctic tundra. You can search it on map on Google. Now here, this yellow colored area is basically the tundra, that is Arctic tundra, because it is very much near the Arctic Circle. So here you can see that the northernmost parts of North America continent, or to be precise, the northernmost parts of the Canada continent, because the inner parts of Canada comes in the taiga region. Now what is actually taiga region, I will be discussing in the subsequent video, where I will tell you the difference between taiga and tundra. But for the time being, the northernmost part of the Canada and some part of Alaska is known to be a part of the tundra biome. Similarly, this Greenland, then the northern part of Europe, Russia. So all of this comes under what? All of this comes under the Arctic tundra, friends. Similarly, Antarctic tundra, this is very much clear to you. The last thing that we are going to know about is the Alpine tundra. What is actually Alpine tundra? And with this Alpine tundra, you are going to associate this tree line or timber line. What is this tree line and timber line? So basically, this Antarctic tundra is a natural region, biome. It is also not having trees. And the extreme low temperatures have been there because of very high elevation. It is actually at a very high elevation. So that is why the temperatures are very low here. Now, as we are going to go towards the poles, okay, then the threshold elevation for Alpine tundra gets lower. And when it reaches sea level, this Alpine tundra merges with the polar tundra. You need to understand this thing, friends. Okay, and this thing can only be explained by the help of a diagram. Suppose this is an equator. Okay, 0 degree equator. If I'm going to go on the north, then northern latitudes come 10 degree north, 20, 30 degree north, 40 degree north. Similarly, if you are going to go to south, 10 degree south, similarly 40 degree south. Now friends, what happens that suppose if there is a mountain here in the equator region, and suppose there is a mountain at 40 degree latitude. Okay friends, so what is happening that you very well know that at the equator, the intensity of sunlight is the highest. Okay friends, so if there is a mountain in the equatorial region, when we are going to go to the top of the mountain, that is when we are going to reduce our elevation in the mountains, what will happen? The temperature will slide gradually because the heat of the sun rays is there. But if we are going to have a mountain at this 40 degree latitude, so when we are going to go at the top of this 40 degree latitude mountain, the temperature will not fall gradually, it will fall faster. Because here the sunlights are not dominant, but here the sunlights are dominant. So this particular statement that as the latitude of a location approaches the poles, the threshold elevation, kindly focus on this thing, for alpine tundra gets lower until it reaches sea level and alpine tundra merges the polar tundra. This means, it says that when there has to be a threshold elevation, for example, when we are going to go up in this mountain, which is at the equator, obviously the level at which there will be a boundary between the forest ecosystem and the alpine ecosystem, that boundary will be very high. Similarly, when we talk about this 40 degree mountain, 40 degree latitude mountain, here the threshold elevation, that is boundary between the forest ecosystem and alpine tundra ecosystem, it is going to be quite lower. And similarly, as we are going to go north, 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 that threshold elevation, that elevation at which there will be a boundary between forest ecosystem and alpine tundra ecosystem, it will be at the sea level. This is the simple scene, friends. So as we come from poles towards the equator, that tree line, that timber line goes higher up in elevation. So obviously the alpine tundra goes higher up in elevation. This is as simple as that, friends. So that is why in alpine tundra, it is very important to have a very high altitude, no matter where that particular mountain is. Okay, so where is this alpine tundra found? It is found in North America, Cordillera, Alps, Pyrenees of Europe, Himalayan and Karakoram ranges of Asia and East of South America, East Rift Mountains of Africa. So here we can see here in this map, friends, here in the Andes, you are going to find these. Then in Northern North America, Cordillera, you are going to find this. Okay, friends, then in Alps here, you are going to find this. In Himalayas and Karakoram range, you are going to find this. And in Urals, you are going to find this. So basically, these are the locations, the general locations, where when we are going to go high up in elevation, we are going to find the alpine tundra biome. This is as simple as that, friends. One more important fact, what is the characteristics of tundra biome? It is extremely very cold. We very well know that. And because of this low temperatures, biodiversity is obviously going to be low. Vegetation structure is going to be very, very simple because lichens, mosses, dwarf shrubs and only grasses are there. Limitation of drainage. Why? Because obviously everything is frozen there. So when everything is frozen, there is no stream, there is no river, there is no water bodies. Obviously, the drainage will be limited. The growth and reproduction system is very, very short. These three things are very much associated with each other. Short season of growth and reproduction, energy and nutrients in the form of dead organic matter, and large population isolations. Because when the short season of warm will come, okay, when the summer season will come, obviously that heat of the sun are not going to reach there much. Okay, so what is happening, friends, that the growth season is very small. So that is why small grasses go. And obviously during this warm season, only the population is found in this area. As soon as the winter starts, the population goes away. So obviously large population oscillations are there, and obviously the life forms which are available there, they die too soon, and because of that, energy and nutrients are present in the form of dead organic matter. So this is the fact, friends. I hope this thing is very much clear to you. So if this video was useful for you, friends, kindly like this video, comment and tell me that how you like this video, and please share these videos with your friends. Please share them on your Instagram and Facebook profile. So thank you for watching, friends. Have a great day and goodbye.